All right, everyone, here we are with Wkhs, Workhorse Group, Inc. And before we jump into this chart, I want to say welcome to all my first-time viewers and investors. Welcome to my channel, Invest for Tomorrow. To all my subscribers, welcome back, and let's jump into this chart. So Workhorse Group, Inc. has continued the bullish run. It's actually broken through the highest point in this recovery of a bullish run here, and it's hit newer highs. It broke through that point up here at 21.54. Now it's slightly below it. So we're going to look at our new resistance levels and our new support levels, as well as talk about the highest point reached and how important it is for the bulls to break through it. So we're going to look at the 50-day moving average and our new points of reference. So let's go ahead and narrow this down based off the last couple hours of the day between the resistance and our support here. And then we're also going to look at how important the highest point is. So for the bulls to get to newer highs and new resistance levels beyond this resistance level that we're looking at now and get further away from the 50-day moving average, they're going to want to break through 22.18. That's the highest point reached in this bullish run from the recoveries from way down here at 15.14, reaching newer highs and new resistance levels. They're going to want to break through 22.18, turn that into a support, and reach newer highs. But before getting there, obviously, they need to break through this resistance. And also, let's look at our 50-day moving average so we know where it stands. So our 50-day moving average is currently at 2020. 2020 is our 50-day moving average. If we fall below it, we'll be in bearish territory. If we stay above it, we'll stay above bullish territory and above the 50-day moving average. So how could the bulls maintain their run, their momentum, and stay above the 50-day moving average? Well, their first step is breaking through this resistance level, and that's 2161. They're going to want to turn 2161 into a support to reach newer highs and work their way up to newer resistance levels, getting deeper into bullish territory. So super important for the bulls to do so and break away from the 50-day moving average in an upward direction. So I want every single investor to be aware, and I want to emphasize, the bulls need to break through this so that the bears don't start to gain control and so that the 50-day moving average does not get closer to the price. Now, on the other hand, we have what the bears want, and the bears want to break through this support, and that's 2103. If 2103 gets broken through, this could be on its way to newer lows, new support levels, and getting closer to the 50-day moving average. Now, I do want every single investor to be aware that we're still in bullish territory if this support gets broken through. So you're going to want to pay close attention to the behavior between support and the 50-day moving average. How quickly is it moving to newer lows? Is it working towards breaking through the 50-day moving average and ending up below into bearish territory? Or are the bulls trying to reappear before it gets closer to bearish territory and bring it back up? So those are the things you want to pay close attention to for tomorrow. 2103 is our support and our first resistance level to break through for the bulls to continue the momentum is 2161. As always, if you found this video helpful and informative, please do so and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell to turn on all notifications and not miss a single video that I post. Share this with your friends and community, and don't forget to hit the like button to let me know you watch this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and let's make some money. At the end of this video, there's going to be a pop-up video, and I go into detail about the S&P 500 index and how it's been rising up several points on scheduled dates. What happens on those scheduled dates, which are the dates that I circled here on the chart and we're going to see for ourselves? Well, the S&P 500 index rises up several points, and by doing so, they're bringing up several ticker symbols, not all of them, but most of them, up with them. And these ticker symbols are rising up 30 cents to $3 per share. And I know it doesn't sound like a lot, but per share, that does add up. And one thing I am really big on is profits. If you put a dollar into the market and you get out with $2, you've made profits. You've done what the whole purpose of being in the market is for, to maximize profits and minimize losses. And with the Federal Reserve pumping the markets on these scheduled dates, bringing the S&P 500 index up, also brings up individual ticker symbols with them. And again, 30 cents to $3 may not sound like a lot of profit per share, but that does add up. And like I say, profits are profits. So we're going to look here at some of the dates so that you guys can see what I talk about in the video. And it's a weekly series. I wouldn't want you guys to miss out on it. Definitely click on the video as it pops up at the end of the video and check it out. But here we are with one of the first pumps in the scheduled dates pumps. So the first one, since the last time that they have released this, they released this on September 14th, and the next one's coming up on October 14th, which is like a week from now. And on the 15th, they scheduled it. And as you can see, this is the 14th, and the 15th is this big green bar, and it rose up. So on the 14th, we were at around 33.84, and it rose up to 34.20. I mean, that's 40 points risen on the S&P 500 index, and that's creating that catalyst for individual ticker symbols to rise up 30 cents to $3. We're going to look at another one here, and the next one was on September 22nd. And here we are on the 21st, after falling from that last pump, and the market had been falling, and you could see that there is volatility on every single day of the market before the dates of the pumps. But on the dates of the pumps are the days that the most green happens, for the most part. Not every time, but for the most part. But on the 21st, which was a Monday, it was rising up, and it rose up to this point here. And the next one was the 22nd. So this is the last 21st candlestick, and this is the first 22nd candlestick. And we were at 32.70. This one rose up all the way up here to this point right here. This was the last 22nd candlestick to 33.19. I mean, if we go back, we were at 32.70, 33.19. That's almost 50 point jump here for the S&P 500 index. And again, individual ticker symbols rose up with it, and it created that catalyst a little bit before the anticipation. And on that date, it rose up. Now on this next pump, which was a little bit different, there was a catalyst formed beforehand, and it rose up to these highs on the 28th of about 33.59. It actually dipped on the date of the next pump, which we see it here, which was on the 29th of September. And the next one was on the 6th, which just happened yesterday. And it actually slightly dipped. Now, not every time is these pumps going to rise up the market like we've seen here by a lot of points, but it still rises it back up or levels it off from hitting newer lows and leveling off the market itself. Because if we look at the previous notes that I did beforehand, it was actually rising up with it. The volatility was there, but you were able to buy, like for example, how we bought here on the 15th and it rose up. Well, it's been falling and then very volatile here, up and down. Beforehand, you can buy at the beginning of the scheduled pump dates and hold a couple weeks and ride out several pumps, and you were going on your way up. But right now, even as the market's going down, it's a great opportunity to take advantage of the fact that the Federal Reserve is pumping the markets, and there's an opportunity to make profits. So here we are on the 29th, and it fell to lows of 33.28, and it rose up to these highs here of 33.49. I know it doesn't sound like a lot, but that's still a 20 point jump after dipping and recovering, and then it continued to work its way up to newer highs. Now here on the 6th, which on the 5th it started to rise, it leveled off. This is the last candlestick of the 5th coming up right now, and we're about to see it here. Yes, this is the last candlestick of the 5th, and it rose up, and all the way to the last candlestick of the 6th, it rose up another 20 points. I mean, we're down here, and it ended up around here. So right now, something I'm noticing is that these pumps are creating less of an effect on the market, but it's creating that upward direction from falling to newer lows, but it's still helping the market rise up. And even though the S&P 500 index is rising several points, there are individual ticker symbols rising up, like I said, 30 cents to $3. Check out the video. I go into more detail. I don't want you guys to miss out on this great information. Click on it. And thank you guys so much for watching, and let's make some money.